Tyre pressure. It's an important but often overlooked safety aspect of driving your vehicle. Too little air can often be as dangerous as too much air in your tyres, but have you ever wondered just how much air your tyre could take before it went bang? Now, you won't be able to do this down at your local garage because the pumps that they've got aren't strong enough. What you need is a specialised piece of kit like this. A cylinder that packs a hefty 3,000 PSI with a valve that can be firmly attached to the Schrader threaded valve on the tyre, and a very long piece of hose so that we can be well back when the tyre goes bang! Overinflation, after all, is a dangerous thing. A recent safety campaign by the tyre industry discovered that 90% of the cars that they had tested had either over or underinflated tyres. Wrongly inflated tyres can increase braking distances and fuel consumption. In fact, most blowouts can be attributed to incorrect pressure, which is what we're hoping to see today. We're using nitrogen gas to inflate the tyre as they do in Formula One. Nitrogen is inert, which means that should there be a spark from the explosion, the gas won't ignite. Now, the average tyre pressure for your bog standard wheel is 30 psi, give or take a few. We're packing 3,000, so we should get the desired result. What we don't know is just how much pressure the tyre can take. And there's the answer. It takes not 100, not 200, but 300 PSI to blow your tyre clean to smithereens.
And if 300 PSI doesn't mean much to you, well, it was enough pressure to blow the alloy wheel apart.
On closer inspection, you can see the damage caused, not by flying bits of rubber, but from the pressure wave created as the tyre burst. This alloy rim has been peeled and buckled.